Which came first, the chicken or the egg?
There's that wonderful old joke about chicken and egg have just made love and they're lying there having a bit of a post-coital cigarette. And the chicken says to the egg, well, that answers that old question. You know, the Irish cure for a cold, my dad always used to say, what you do is you get into bed with a hat and a bottle of whiskey and you put the hat on the end left bedpost and then you drink until you can see it on the right.
What use is a goose? Sandy Toksvig.
Is it toilet paper? No, seriously.
Sandy, that is bizarre. Why did you say that?
Well, because I once read this book by Rabelais. I think it's called Gargantua. And he recommended that the best thing for toilet paper was a live goose. And I have yet to check into a five-star hotel without a sense of disappointment.
I have the quotation from Rabelais' Gargantua. I have, answered Gargantua, by a long and curious experience, found out a means to wipe my bum. The most lordly, the most excellent, and the most convenient that was ever seen. I wipe my tail with a hen, with a cock, with a pullet, with a calfskin, with a hare, with a pigeon, with a cormorant. There is none in the world comparable to the neck of a goose that is well down, for you will thereby feel in your knockhole a most wonderful pleasure.
So I love that. Why do we need swear words when you've got knockhole?
Yeah. We ought to hear it from Mary Anderson, 1903.
Oh, Mary Anderson.
Do you know about Mary Anderson?
I do, Mary Anderson.
Tell me about her.
She invented the windscreen wiper.
Yeah, absolutely. And, you are a phantom.
Well, what I love about that is that it had to be a woman who invented the windscreen wiper because up until then, men have been going, don't be silly, dear, I can see perfectly well. Actually, Ronnie and I were talking about how wonderful boys are because they live in this kind of very kind of clear world about themselves. And when my son was about 6, he had a friend over. And his friend said, what's it like having two mummies then? He said, it's marvellous. And he said, if one of them's poorly, you've still got one to do for you.
Excellent. Which is most dangerous? 1,000 bananas,
ooh,
half a litre of wine, 1.4 cigarettes, or 2 days in New York?
You could fall on quite a lot of those banana peels.
This professor from Stanford developed the micromort. And a micromort is a 1 in a million chance of death.
So how many micromorts in a banana?
Well, if you take the normal background risk in the UK, it's actually 41.6 micromorts. So the chances of sudden death in Britain from leading a normal life are about 4 in 100,000.
What, 4 people die unexpectedly from eating a banana?
No, no, just that's background. This is just background. We're not come to the bananas
yet. Sorry, I'm overexcited.
Yeah. Your ordinary risk,
yes,
of dying suddenly is 4 in 100,000.
I've got it now.
Right, but activities that raise the level of risk from 41.6 micromorts, which is the average risk we all share, by 1 micromort alone, are smoking 1.4 cigarettes yourself, 40 tablespoons of peanut butter.
So I'm sorry, I'm still on the bananas. You have to. You have to eat 1,000 bananas.
If you ate 1,000 bananas, not necessarily all at once, because that would kill you straight away.
Yes.
Honestly, you'll burst. The point is, every 1,000 bananas you eat,
yes,
your chances of sudden death increase by 1 micromort.
What is the matter with scientists? Who? Who is going to eat 1,000 bananas? Why would you eat one of this time?
Lifetime, I've eaten 1,000 bananas.
Yeah, I reckon about it.
So should you be counting how many bananas you've eaten?
No, it's only 1 micromort. It's a 1 in a million chance.
But how does the 1,000th banana kill
because
you?
Of the level of radioactivity. Oh, God. For every 1,000 you eat, you've already got 41.6 micromorts.
I feel unwell.
What key role did a Puritan pig play in the trial of George Spencer in 1641?
Is that the actual pig we're looking
no,
at?
No, that is not the actual pig, because that's a photograph of a modern pig posing as a 1641 pig.
A rather similar picture of myself at a spa.
You've got too fewer nipples.
Well, certainly the nipples were a surprise. My grandfather had had 2 glass eyes, and yet he could see. So what happened was he lost one eye. I mean, he wasn't careless, he was ill. And and he had a glass eye made, which was perfect, exactly like his other perfectly working blue Scandinavian eye. And then he had one made that was bloodshot. And it was known as Grandpa's party eye. And he... on a, in a box on the mantelpiece, and when he was going out for the evening, he'd take out the false blue one, and he'd put in the bloodshot one, and he'd say, I'm going out now, and I shan't be back till they match.
Oh, that's brilliant!
That's brilliant.
Fantastic. Now, why don't we have more women as guests on QI? You may well ask.
Oh, I know this.
No,
female. No, up to you. Is it because women are just not funny? Yeah.
No, that's right. But we're good at other things. We're good at raising kittens and knitting cakes.
Yeah. I've heard this a lot. I've heard that women aren't funny, and I think there's a truth in this. I think that there is a scientific, possibly, relationship between a sense of humour and the male sex organ.
People are always laughing at mine.
Yeah, well, there you are.
Is this to do with the fact that people always say there aren't as many female comedians as there are men? Because you know what? There are loads of female comedians. It's just that we just don't see them because they're systematically rounded up and kept in a pen just outside Harwich.
Harwich?
Yes, Harwich. But you can go and see them and you can adopt them online. Yeah. You can go and you can visit them and you can feed them lines and you might get a joke back sometimes. And then sometimes some of them escape and they disguise themselves as male comedians. But you can always tell which ones the male comedians are, the ones with the beards. Just like Life of Brian.
Bill Bailey.
Bill Bailey.
Clearly a woman.
But, you know, they very... It's really rare to be allowed to sit next to a female comedian. I don't know what they're worried that our cycles will suddenly synchronise.
I'm not. I'm in disguise. I'm Rory Bremner. I'm doing...
Hello. Actually... Is it because once you get them started, they don't shut up?
Whoa.
What are you doing about it?
Oh, I say.